I know everyone has been waiting for this moment for quite some time. And trust me, I've been very, very busy lately. And because it's the festive season, I had to do some family time as well. So today we have the time to install the full channel with the 619s and the mids. So we're going to show you guys every single thing, how to get the job done 100%. And I bought some few other stuff as well. Later, I'm going to break you guys through that real quick. But I bought a few stuff, and trust me, those small stuff I actually bought separately from the speakers and amps. It actually cost quite expensive if you have to like add everything together. So if you want a proper sound system in your car, you unfortunately have to spend the money to make sure that you have a proper and reliable sound system without anything taking a light. So I'm just going to break you guys through what I just bought for today's video. So as many of you guys already know, I already bought the 4-channel amplifier, I bought the mids, and I bought the 619s. Those are we going to install right now. And separately from the speakers and the amplifier, I bought all this laying right here. So I'm just going to break you guys through what I bought and the reason why I bought it. So I bought two sets of RCAs. The reason for that was I initially wanted to run one set of RCAs for just the subs. I already have a pair of RCAs in the car, but I thought of replacing it, which is not really needed, but I bought two sets just in case. But I'm rather thinking of running this RCAs for the front speakers, this RCAs for the rear speakers, and that way I can still fine tune it 100% on the double din. Here I have a packet of terminals, so I bought a few fuses as well, because the fuses I need for this split system, I'm not sure what it is called though, it's like a split block, yeah, a fuse distribution block. I had to buy this because the reason I had to buy this is because I'm running two amplifiers. So you put the one 4-gauge wire in here and it splits to two, and that way you're still running a fuse system, and that is a very, very nice way to set up your system if you're gonna run two amplifiers in your car. So I bought that, and obviously I just bought a fuse just in case. I bought a few terminals to make everything look very, very neat. I had to buy wiring for the car, so what I did was I bought a 2 meter each side for the 6x9s because the amplifier will be at the back, and I bought a 4 meter each side for the mids in front because all of the wires will be running to the amplifier, which will be at the back. And obviously I bought this cover. Just keep in mind, I won't be using the entire cover, I only need the top piece. I will be cutting it here and here just to use this top part for the top part of the double din, so that way I have everything neatly wrapped up in front. Because at the moment in the car, you guys can see it has a gap right there, and that piece is just gonna cover that gap right there, and that's all I need on the inside or the interior of the car. I just want to give a shout out to my cousin Jamie and Logan. Logan's in the other garage for helping me with today's video. They're gonna help me with the full installation of the 6x9s. And I know many of you guys actually like the fact that I'm gonna hide the 6x9s underneath this cover. Just keep in mind, I will still need to manufacture some brackets in order to mount the 6x9s under here. Which I'm going to show you guys shortly as well, what we had, what we have planned out for that entire setup right there. We did not figure it out just yet, but we're going to do some rough planning, and hopefully we can get that sorted, because I do not want to cut holes in the backboard, and that way my subs will still be secured. And the main reason why I'm not cutting any holes in the backboard is because then the speaker will be right on top of the subwoofer, and that might cause it to damage the subwoofer or scrape against the rubber or something like that. And as many know, we already installed the monoblock in the car. So what I'll be doing inside of the car, this is the power wire right here. So the power wire, I'm going to run to the distribution block, and it will be split in two. And from there, I'll be running it to both amplifiers. I'll be mounting everything to the back seat. The only reason why I'm using only one RCA here is because there's only one input on the double din, so then I can only use the one input for this RCA. So this RCA I'm going to keep in the car, and I'll just add the other two sets of RCAs for the front and the rear, so hopefully we can get that sorted. And obviously the ground, I'll be having two ground wires inside of the car. I'll have a separate ground wire for each amplifier, and the remote wire, I'll just run a remote wire, a short wire from this monoblock to the 4-channel amplifier. Hopefully I can get that amplifier mounted the same way as this one right here. I know I was initially going to run a full audio, full energy audio sound system, but I just couldn't let go of the bargain for the 24,000 watt monoblock. and for the two Targa 4D subs. So we'll be keeping this in for the time being, and hopefully I can do upgrade to the Energy Audio subs, but for now the sound system will have to do, and trust me, it actually really plays amazing. So we're gonna start straight away with installing the 6x9 first, because I think that might just be the most difficult part, and the way to get brackets to like fit the 6x9s underneath those covers. So we're gonna start off with that. I'm gonna put you guys on a timeline while we'll be busy figuring out that, and as soon as we're done with it, we can actually show you guys and explain to you guys how we achieved to mount the 6x9 underneath those two brackets on the sides. So let's start with the time lapse real quick with the installation of the 6x9s. So guys, what we managed to do is that we got like 8 of these clips right here, so we kind of made these clips ourselves. You literally just need L clips. You can buy these normal metal clips, but because the hardware store is closed today, we made our own L brackets or clips, whatever you want to call it, and then we just mounted it to this piece of cover at the back, and obviously the L has to be set or be placed like this, and then you can literally just screw on your 6x9 to the cover. Very, very easy, very, very simple. Just a little bit of the 6x9 will be sticking out on the inside, because you don't want it to be sticking out on the outside, because otherwise we'll be hitting against the frame or the body of the car. And well, that's the best we could fit it at the moment. And the speaker is not touching at the bottom, because there's like a lot of space underneath right here, and obviously you can put it under here, but unfortunately the reason why we had to put it a little bit to the back is because the seat belt unfortunately needs to be mounted in that exact same spot, which is right here. So we're just gonna mount it to the sides once again, and you guys can literally see that both 6x9s are hidden below these covers at the back. So yeah, an hour later and we got both 6x9s installed at the back. So if you check it from this perspective right here, you won't even notice there are 6x9s at the back. And as you guys can see from here, there we have the tweeter, or the, I don't know what you call that, on the speaker. It's sticking out right there, and obviously it's going to give us nice clarity at the back as well. So what me and Jamie are going to do right now, we already got the 6x9s mounted. So what we're going to do right now is that we're going to put on these terminals, which is right here. This make your setup look way, way neater, because we will be sliding this into this section right here of the channels. So it will look very, very neat if you check it from the back. So the red will be for the positive and the blue will be for the negative. And on the other side of the wires, we'll obviously have to install some speaker terminals, which is, well, right there. So we're gonna have a negative and a positive speaker terminals. We're gonna do all four wires, which is two wires are 4 meter running to the front mids, and the other two are 2 meters running to the 6x9s at the back. I will mount the 4-channel amplifier to the seat along, so I can mount it to the seat this way. I'm guessing either this way around, like this, or I can mount it the exact same way, like this. What do you guys think? I think that way will be perfect. Then both amplifiers are that way. So I think I'm gonna mount it like that. And obviously it's very, very easy to access all the wires. So I'll put that block right here, or maybe nice in the middle. And from there we can start running the wires to whatever side is needed. Like I said, Jamie already started with the wires, so as soon as he's done, then we'll show the progress we made on the wires. But I'll start stripping the door panels along and start figuring out the way to install the mids in front. The goal is to install the mids in front, but to still keep like the standard look of the car, if it makes sense like that. So I kind of want to keep this cover right here. So I'm going to try to keep this cover right here, but if I can't keep it, I'm just going to remove it and put the mid in there with the mids cover going over that. Not a problem at all, but if I can get the mid behind this cover, that will work out perfectly for me. One thing I'd like to mention once again is that we're going to run one speaker wire down this side for the front speaker, one speaker wire from that side to the front speaker, and obviously you're going to run the 1 6.9 wire down here, and the other 6.9 wire down here. We're going to run it underneath this material right here, and it's going to be coming out underneath of the seat, and then we're going to connect it to the 4-channel amplifier. That might be very, very quick, and just keep in mind, I already laid out a set of RCAs previously, this side around. So the other two sets I will be laying this side as well, and I'll be running them straight to the double dun. So I will remove the double dun real quick as well after I'm done mounting the 4-channel and installing the mids. Then I can connect the RCAs, connect all the speakers, and hopefully we can start tuning soon. But I'm gonna put you guys on a timer real quick while I'll be busy mounting the amplifier to the seat and installing the front mids. I have another quick update for you guys right here. So what I did was I connected this distribution block here in the middle. As you guys can see right there, that looks very, very neat, and I'm kind of impressed with like how neat the setup is like gonna look. I really connected up all the power wires. So what I did is I connected the power wire coming from the battery to the distribution block, and from here it splits into two, which you can connect to both amplifiers. This one right here, the remote wire, I just connected a normal wire from this amplifier to this one, and obviously I had each amplifier grounded to its own mounting point. So on each seat belt holder I had a ground, so I grounded one amplifier there, the other one right here, so each one has its own ground, and that makes it look even more neater. So what we're doing right now is that we connected up the mids to the door panels real quick. So unfortunately those covers don't fit with the mids, but I have some good news is that with the Energy Audio covers, the mids look nice and neat. So as you guys can see right there, it looks very, very neat. I'm super impressed with how the mid actually sits on the door, and I think it looks kind of original. It's just if you see the Energy Audio name right there, but it still looks very, very original. So at the moment I'm gonna put you guys on the time lapse while we're busy laying the wires for the front speakers as well as the rear speakers as well as the RCAs. I already explained to you guys what I gonna do. I'm gonna lay the RCAs on the driver side, I'm gonna lay the speaker wires on the passenger side, and that way we can connect all the wires to the amplifiers, and then hopefully everything works. So let's keep our fingers crossed, because it is quite late, it's like before 10 or after 10. So we're gonna try to finish up the entire job, and then after that we're gonna start tuning up the system, and we'll briefly explain to you guys how to tune up your system in whatever way you would like it. If you want like some mid bass and some vocal out of your 6.9s or your mids, you can tune it that way, or you can just tune it with simply just giving vocal from the 6.9 and the mid. So that depends fully on you, but we're gonna continue because it is getting late. We don't want to wake up the neighbors by turning up the system too much, but we need to get the system tuned after we're done with the installation. So the installation is taking a little bit longer as we expected, but we want a neat job done to the car, and that's why we're taking our time. So we're going to dive into it real quick, and we're going to put you guys on a time lapse while we'll be busy with the installation.
When you feel it's hopeless, when you think that you lost, oh, I will take your hand and we'll rise up from the dust.
So guys, it is the next day and we got everything installed. As you guys can see right here, we have the 6.9s underneath the covers on each side. So here's the one this side, the one that side. Just guys, keep in mind we had to manufacture our own brackets to like get it mounted underneath this cover. And another thing I would like to tell you guys, or a tip I can leave to any of you guys would like to do this conversion or the speaker conversion to your car set, just make sure you mount the speaker a little bit more to the boot side, to the bootlet side, because it hits against this body of the car right here. This is like the petrol like tank side here. So just keep in mind whenever you're mounting the speaker to mount it a little bit more to the back than that side, because we barely got everything fitted in this side. So it still worked out, but it was a very tight fit. Here we have everything connected, and unfortunately I was only able to use two RCAs because I only had like two RCA outputs for the speakers and one RCA output for the amplifier or the monoblock which is running the subwoofers. So I connected up one RCAs with two of these splits, so I'm running them to the front mids and to the rear 6x9s, and I'm gonna get to in detail on that with you guys shortly. But there we have the monoblock, and that's connected to the subwoofers right there. And obviously I have this distribution block right here which splits the power wire to both amplifiers. You guys can see here's one wire coming to this amplifier and the other one is going to the monoblock, and obviously I grounded each one separately to the body, and just the remote wire I took from the monoblock I took over to this one right here. To make everything look a bit neat, I just used some cable ties and some terminals on this entire amplifier right here. Unfortunately I couldn't use terminals right there because this is round mounting points where you have to mount the wire into the amplifier, so unfortunately I couldn't use any terminals on this monoblock. But everything looks quite neat to me. This is the neatest I could get it at the moment. Unfortunately I still need to buy another split for this, but luckily I still had an extra split for this one right here. The reason why I'm not connecting up both RCAs is because unfortunately at the back of the double DIN in front it only has one input, so that's why I only could use one and I had to split it to the monoblock right there. But here we have everything connected up. Let me just briefly explain to you guys how to tune your amplifier. I'm referring to the 4-channel amplifier right now, if you want to tune your 6x9s or your mids or whatever speaker you're running on it. This is the best way I could explain to you guys. So guys, this channel right here, this is the rear channel. So guys, HPF is for your high frequency. You use this when you want to adjust like the vocal of your car. The low frequency, that's when you adjust your bass. And obviously the gain is it depends on how much power you want on the two channels. On HPF, if you turn up the HPF all the way to the max, you're only going to hear some clarity. The more you turn it down anti-clockwise, then you're going to hear this going to be coming a little bit mid-bass with the 6x9s. If it makes sense like that, that's the best way I can explain it. And obviously if you adjust the gain higher, that way you're going to get more power and you're going to give more power to the 6x9s or whatever speaker you're running on this current channel. And I'm not 100% sure about this, but all that I know about this switch right here is that whenever you adjust this one upwards, it really says here bass boost. So if you adjust this one up to 6 dB, then obviously you get more power to the amplifier. And if you adjust it to 12 dB, which I'm guessing is decibels, and if you adjust it, the higher you adjust it, the more power you get to the two channels right there. And obviously the same applies to the front channel. But the front channel, you can only run a HPF setup, meaning you can only run mids or your 6x9s, depending whatever setup you're going to be running in the car. So make example, you just have some subs in and you have some 6x9s in. You run your 6x9s on this front channel right here. You turn your gain up to where you feel comfortable. You turn up your HPF all the way, depending if you want some bass or not. If you don't want some bass, turn up the HPF all the way. If you want some mid bass with that, you turn it a little bit back, say like 3/4 of the way. Yeah, you turn it up like 3/4 of the way. That way you get like mid bass and more vocal. Then on this one right here, you just put it on LPF, which will be right there. That's LPF, the one in the middle. You turn the HPF all the way down and you turn up the LPF depending on how much bass you would like. And obviously then you adjust it by your gain. So that's basically the basics. Unfortunately, that is the best way I can explain it. And trust me guys, like I'm not sure if it will justify like on camera, but the system really plays like it plays quite well. And unfortunately, I'm gonna try to play you guys a song, but if I can't, please excuse me, because it literally doesn't justify it on camera, like how amazing the Energy Audio actually plays. I'm really impressed with the Energy Audio, but it's not the best on the market, to be honest. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I'm very impressed with this 4-channel amplifier right here. It's super strong, no lies. But I think the car would have played a little better if it had a Pioneer or something else in. Because in my Honda I have a Sony split system in front where you have the mud, you have a 2-liter and you connect it up to a split, and from there you run it to your 4-channel amplifier, and that's that way you get mud bass and vocals. So that like splits off everything right there, and trust me, that one plays a little bit better. But this will I have to do. I'm totally happy with everything I have in the car at the moment. Another thing I forgot to mention is that I actually got the strip in fitted right here, just above the tape. So guys, you can literally just make your own one like this, but I didn't feel like making myself one, so I just bought that cover and I literally just cut this piece out of the cover, and as you guys can see that there, it looks quite neat, so I'm quite impressed with it. I'm just gonna make it look a little bit neater. I have to trim it off a little bit more on top, and that way everything will be hundreds. But for now, I'm 100% satisfied with my system. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I hope everything was helpful enough. I hope the review was kind of enough. But I'm gonna do like a full in-depth review of everything, because I'm gonna do my research a little bit, and I can briefly explain to you guys every single thing that some people kind of know about these systems and how they judge these systems and how they give it a proper rating. So that way you guys can decide yourself if you guys would like to buy an Energy Audio sound system or a Targa setup for your subs or whatever. But for me personally guys, I'm totally impressed with my sound system. I hope you guys like the idea of hiding the 6x9s like under the cover, this side and that side right there. Like me, you guys wouldn't notice that I have a sound system in unless if you check the double and right there. Stay tuned for my next video. I think you guys like my next video, because my next video might just be for the Toyota boys, because yeah, I'm installing coilovers in the 2012, so I hope you guys enjoy that video. But guys, like, subscribe, follow along, more related content. Guys, once again, be safe this festive holiday. I hope you guys had a wonderful Christmas and a happy new year, or upcoming happy new year. Remember guys, stop racing and go stars.